Myself Dr. M.K. Gokulu, Department of Mathematics, Government College, Ajmer. Today, we are going to discuss three important issues about permutations. Earlier, we discussed what are the permutations, its definition, cyclic permutation, and related topics of permutation. Today, we are going to discuss three important issues, one of which is every permutation can be expressed as a composition of disjoint cycles. Yes. Let us try to understand this phenomena with the help of a simple example. Say we have a permutation belonging to 10 elements, that is say 1 to 10. So S is the set having 10 elements 1, 2 and 10. Now one of the permutation belonging to this one is say F, and F is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And for the simplicity, I can use this as say 2, 3, 4, 1, and 6, 7, and 5, 9, 9. 10 and 8. Technically, I use this because from here we can say the image of 1, we can make the cycles of different cycles of this permutations H. Image of 1 is 2, image of 2 is 3, image of 3 is 4, and image of 4 is 1. This is one of the cycle. Second, the remaining element, all the remaining elements are 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, the set, let us try to define another set containing the elements 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This set T is not this set T is actually nothing but S minus 1, 2, 3, 4 elements. 1, 2, 3, 4 elements. 1, 2, 3, and 4 elements. T is this one. So again, we define another function on T at 5, 6, 7, 8. 9 and 10, and the images of these elements under this is 6, 7, and 5, and 9, 10, and 8. So, here again we find a cycle, means image of 5 is 6, 5 is 6, 6 is 7, and image of 7 is 5. And remaining elements are, we again define a set U, and we find set U is nothing but set T minus the elements 5, 6, 7. 5, 6 and 7 will get the another set. This is set as 8, 9, and 10, and permutation on this is say H. H is 8, 9, 10, and image of 8, 9, 10 is 9, 10, and 8. So, and this is nothing but the cycle. Image of 8 is 9, and 9 is 10. 8 is 9, 9 is 10, 10 is 8. So, in phases, we got got this 1, 2, 3, 4, first 4 elements, then 5, 6, 7, we can join this with G and this with H. Finally, we can write 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, 6, 7, 5, 6, 7, and then 8, 9, 10. So, finally, we got this permutation as the composition of disjoint cycles. These are the disjoint cycles. Mathematically, if you want to derive this expression in mathematical way, so we can take, say, S as a set of n elements x1, x2, and xr plus 1, and so on, xn up to n elements. These are the n elements. First cycle that we got from this is, say, x1, x2, x3, and xr. This is first cycle, and from remaining elements, we can get different cycle like this, as cycle this alpha 1, alpha 2, and so on, alpha n, alpha 4, 5, 6, 7, n, which we, whatever I may write, these are the different cycles, so we can use alpha I. These are the different cycles. So these permutation related to this S is, this is say x1, x2, xn, xr, these are the x, image of x1 is x2, x2 is 3, x3, and xr is 1, and xr plus 1 having some image up to xn. In the same fashion as we discuss here, we can find different cycle, disjoint cycles related to this set for any permutation F. In this way, we can find different cycles. So every permutation can be expressed as composite of disjoint cycles. And the second task is before us is to every cycle. Cycle can be expressed H a composition of disjoint transpositions. Transpositions. So here a permutation can be expressed as composition of disjoint cycles, and every cycle can be expressed as a composition of disjoint transposition, and combining these two results we can get every permutation can be expressed as the composition of disjoint transposition. So let us take, this is a cycle x1, x2. And earlier in my earlier lecture, I defined the transposition. Transposition is nothing but a cycle of length 2, and it is an odd permutation. Cycle of length 2, and it is an odd permutation. So let us take this cycle XR, and we can get different transposition of this cycle as x1 and xr minus 1, and so on, x1 and x3 and x1 and x2. Means we can break this cycle in different number of transpositions. Number of different transposition. Let us say practically we can take this as we let us have a cycle 1, 2, 3, simple cycle of 1, 2, 3, and this can be broken as transpositions 1, 3 and 1, 2. These are the transpositions. Means if we operate these two permutations, these are the cyclic permutations, representation of a permutation. So if we operate these two permutations, we will get this cycle as a outcome of it. So every cycle can be expressed as disjoint transpositions. In this way, we can break this cycle in these transpositions, and the way of representation of transposition is not unique, but we can also represent this transposition as 3, 3, 1 and 3, 2. So representation of transposition is not unique, but number of transposition in each case, see here, in each case remains the same. So length of this cycle is 3, number of transposition is 1 less than that. That means total number of transposition for this length of the cycle is 1 less than that length of the cycle. So we get 2 transposition in this case, and also in this case we get 2 transpositions. So number of transposition is always 1 less than the length of this cycle. Now we define some results about transpositions and properties about transposition H. Transposition is always a odd permutation. Transposition is always an odd permutation. Identity permutation. Identity is always an even permutation. Third one, if we operate two even permutation, means we combine two even permutation, even operated by even permutation, we will get an even permutation. If we operate an odd permutation with an odd permutation, we will get even permutation. And if we operate an even permutation with an odd permutation, we will get odd permutation. These are the 5 basic results which help us to prove some more results about permutations, and we should remember these ones. So one result that we can draw from our earlier example, that if the length of the cycle is odd one, then naturally we will get number of transposition as even. And if the length of the cycle is odd one, then we will get number of transposition that we get will be odd one. So length of cycle is even, we will get odd transpositions. If length of the cycle is odd, then we will get number of transposition as even. And in order to prove the order of the permutation, whether the permutation is even or odd, whether the permutation is even or odd, what we should do? In order to find whether the given permutation is odd or even, using these two earlier theorems, we should break the permutation in cycles, and then every cycle can be represented as the number of transposition. So cycles, and finally cycles can be broken into the transpositions. And if the number of transposition is odd, then permutation is odd. If number of transposition is even, permutation is even. So we can verify the result that whether the given permutation is even or whether the given permutation is odd with the help of this result. So now we will prove one more theorem about permutation, that the theorem is set of all even permutations. If we have a finite set, number of elements are here. For the sake of simplicity, let us take a finite set as having elements 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, and 3. These are the three elements, and number of permutations that we can generate from this set will be factorable 3. That is, number of permutations that we can find are factorable 3, means 6 permutations. What are these 6 permutations? Are 1, 2, 3. Say it is identity permutation, and A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, B, 1, 2, 3, and 3, 1, 2, C, 3 is equal to 1, 2, 3, and 1, 3, 2, and D is equal to 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2, 1, and E is equal to 1, 2, 3, and 2, 1, 3. These are the all possible 6 permutations for this set. This finite set we can get, these are the 6 permutations. Now, whether these are the even permutations or odd permutation, we can use our earlier result here. This is nothing but its identity permutation, and identity permutation is always even permutation as we defined earlier. Now, what is this? This is a permutation with this cycle 1, 2, and 3. And in
breaking this cycle into transpositions, we will get 1, 3 and 1, 2 as transposition. And number of transposition are E1, so it is an E1 permutation. E1 permutation. This is an E1 permutation. And again, here 1, 3 and image of 1 is 3. 3, image of 3 is 2. 1, 3, 2. And in breaking this and in transposition, we get these two distinct transpositions. And number of transposition is E1, therefore it is an E1 permutation. These are the three E1 permutations. Again, look here. This is a permutation having this cycle as 2 and 3. And only single cycle means it is a transposition. So it is an odd permutation. This is again 1, 3. This is 1, 3, and this is again odd permutation, and this is 1, 2, 1, 2, 8, again odd permutation. So, here out of these 6 permutations, we get 3 even permutations and 3 odd permutations. Now, our theorem says that set up all even permutation even permutations A, we define the, we represent this set as AN. Set up all even permutation forms a group and order of this group is factorial n by 2. Means we have say S is the set having n element x1, x2 and xn are n elements. For this finite set, we can define how many permutations that we can define on this. That is factorial n permutations. We can find factorial n permutations for this set, and out of these factorial n permutations, some may be even, some may be odd. And we need to prove that even set of even permutation, out of these odd or even permutations, we extract the even permutations, and finally we have to prove that even set of all even permutations, that is An is the set of all even permutation, and this set An is forms a group, and again, the order of this group is factorial n by 2. Here, practically, we can see easily all this. But mathematically, how we can prove this result? So, first of all, we should try to prove it a set An as a group, and then find order of this group. So, in order to prove that it is a group, what we should do need to do is closure property, that is to behold, means these are the factorial n permutations, and if we operate any two permutations, final result will also be a permutation. And even permutation, as we know, this is the set of even permutation, and as we know, composition of two even permutations always give an even permutation. Means composition of two even, let us take two even permutation from two arbitrary even permutation from this set and operate composite, we can find the composite them, we can find the result is a permutation and which is even, because composition of two even permutation is even permutation. So closure property holds good. Second, associative property. For this associative property, we know the permutations are all functions, one onto functions. So composite of function is again composite of function holds the associative property. Therefore, associative property holds good. Composition of function is associative, holds associative property. Therefore, associative property holds good. Now, identity. What is identity? We all earlier defined that identity permutation is even permutation. Therefore, out of these factorial n permutations, in this set, even permutation automatically appears. Therefore, even permutation is a part of this set, so identity exists here. And finally, inverse. We know the inverse of any permutation, any even permutation is again an even permutation. So we can straightforward say that inverse, if f is a permutation, f is an even permutation, then f inverse is also an even permutation. Therefore, if f inverse also belongs to this set, say due to closure property and inverse property, we can find that inverse of 2 f and f inverse gives us identity permutation, and which is a part of an, and f inverse and f composition of these two again a even permutation in this set. Therefore, inverse property holds good. Thus, we can say that this set permutations on this set having even permutations related to this set are always forms a group. Now it remains to prove that number of even permutations are factorial n by 2. How we can prove this? Number of even permutations. Let us try to prove this result also. The order of the group is factorial n by 2. So, let us try to prove that order of this set of even permutation is factorial n by 2. Let us say factorial n, total number of permutation defined on this set is factorial n. So out of these factorial n permutations, we have e1, e2 and en as even permutations, and o1, o2 and or are all permutations. Means total number of permutations, how many total number of permutations? Factorial n. So factorial n is equal to m plus r. These are the m elements and these are the r elements. So m plus r will be equal to factorial n. These are the even permutations and these are the odd permutations. Now let us try alpha as a transposition. Let us have a transposition alpha is a transposition, and let us multiply, operate this alpha with e1. What we will get? This is odd, our transposition is the odd permutation, alpha into E1, it is even permutation and it is odd permutation, odd one. So the resultant will be an odd permutation. So alpha E1 is odd permutation. Similarly, alpha E2 is odd permutation and alpha EM is odd. These are all odd permutations. These are all odd permutations and no two permutations are same. Suppose if we have EI, alpha EI is equal to alpha EJ, then what will happen? EI is equal to EJ. But no two elements are, these are distinct elements. So these EI is equal to EJ. This applies. Why this happens? Alpha is a transposition and we can, since this forms a group, so we can apply left cancellation law and EI is equal to EJ. But we know these are the distinct E1 permutations. So EI will not equal to, EI will not equal to EJ. So our supposition is Q, means these are the n different, these are the odd permutations. But here we see that odd permutations are R, so definitely n will less than or equal to R. This is one of the result. And again, if we operate this alpha with odd permutation, then what we will get? O1 alpha O2 and alpha OR. What is this? This is odd permutation, this is odd permutation, and composition of two odd permutation is a even permutation, so it is even. These are all even permutations, even. And again, with the same logic, no two even permutations are similar or same. So, O alpha OI is not equal to alpha OJ, means OI is not equal to OJ. These are all distinct even permutations. But we know that even permutations are n, so r must be less than or equal to n, and from here and here we find that r is equal to n, and using this result r is equal to n, we can say r is equal to n is equal to factorial n by 2. So total number of even permutations will be factorial n by 2. This is the result, that total number of even permutations will form a group and its order is factorial n by 2. Sometimes it is asked that number of odd permutations are also factorial n by 2. But whether this will be a group or not, naturally set of all odd permutation will not form a group, because identity will not be there. Identity permutation is an even permutation and that will not be a part of the odd permutation set of odd permutation. Therefore they will not form a group. Now in next lecture we will talk about subgroups. Thank you to all.